Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm.
I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
There is plenty of blame to go around.
What does that mean?
You forced my hand.
This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe.
We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our aerial.
No fucking chance.
I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Yes.
Let's leave. For real.
If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
What would it take to convince you?
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother. I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Of course. In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah. Your birth mother. I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Chloe.
Und damit hallo und herzlich willkommen zu Life is Strange Before the Storm, Episode 3. Und ich habe gerade schnell noch meinen Jacke angezogen, weil ich dachte, ich habe doch Zeit, aber nein. Ging doch schneller los als gedacht. Ich werde jetzt nicht so lange aufnehmen, denn ich muss auch irgendwann ins Bett. Und wir sind jetzt in der dritten Episode, in der letzten. Und wir schauen mal, was passiert noch. Okay. Ich bin hier, du kannst das. Sie kann das.
You can handle this. Not without you.
Dann gehen wir einmal zu Rachel. Und wir haben nicht viel zu tun. Können wir sie ansehen? Nein. Ja, wende dich zum Ferngleich und halte. Ich drücke. Achso, S. Entschuldigung. Ansehen.
When I was in high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long.
Ich finde es aber ziemlich krass gerade, wie man das jetzt alles sehen, wie man die Geschichte erzählt bekommt von ihr.
She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape.
Wie Rachel, irgendwie. Sehr beliebt, jeder liebt sie, jeder Junge will mit ihr ausgehen. Mega Leidenschaft und irgendwie kommt mir das bei Rachel auch nicht so vor, als hätte sie konkrete Zukunftspläne. Hauptsache nur raus, Hauptsache weg.
When Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father is the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind. However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sarah, the need to escape was always there. Over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. Was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied. Anyone or anything. Even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again. What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel, it was true. We kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her that I was happy for her. That she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done. But after all the people she hurt. All the lives she destroyed. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world. The chance to be your mother. And she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again, and again, and again, to keep you safe.
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
Das ist jetzt wirklich nicht seine Entscheidung.
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
When I left Sarah, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. I mean, people change, right?
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Rachel. I think I need to lie down.
I
can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
Jetzt sind wir richtig im Spiel wieder. Ich war ja schon am Ende der zweiten Episode ziemlich geschockt. Ja, ist ihre Mutti. Und jetzt noch die Geschichte, die ist echt krass. Und klar, ja, die Sarah war Rachel ja ziemlich egal. Muss ich jetzt auch sagen. Kam halt auch mir so vor. Aber trotzdem ist das nicht seine Entscheidung. Und ich glaube, Wedge ist auch schlau genug, um selber zu entscheiden.
This seems like a James and Rose bookshelf. I can't imagine Sarah here instead.
Alles, was wir eigentlich schon gesehen haben, aber jetzt mit neuen Texten. Reden, ja.
Wonder what James is thinking right now.
Ja, nicht. Ich frage erstmal die Rose. Und das hier hat hier Rachel zerstört.
Holy shit. Rachel completely destroyed that table.
Heftig, heftig. Wir hatten eine... Hier eine Person. Die Sarah. Die Mutter von Rachel. Einmal durchlesen. Und das müssten wir neu haben. Das nicht. Oder? Warte. Nee. Das ja. Gruppen-SMS? Okay. Mal anders hinsetzen. Dana schreibt, Rachel und Chloe, wo seid ihr jetzt? Weil wir sind auf der Party der Besetzung. Juliet schreibt, ich habe Rachel schon 8-mal getextet. Hey, ich glaube nicht, dass wir noch kommen... Chloe, du solltest kommen. Herz, Herz. Hey, Chloe, du warst großartig süße. Hey, Chloe, super gemacht. Burg? Hat die beim Stück mitgemacht? Eigentlich nicht. Ich glaube, ich habe die nicht gesehen. Danke, aber ich kann nicht. Aber du warst umwerfend. Ohne dich hätte es keine Vorführung gegeben. Im Ernst, komm einfach. Bring Rachel mit. Tut mir leid, Leute. Wir haben gerade ernsthafte... Familienprobleme, Drama, 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 alles.
I can't even imagine how she must be feeling.
Hä? Wartet mal. Okay. Ich höre Stimmen, die wahrscheinlich nicht da sind.
Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point, considering everything.
Okay, Rose.
Kann ich irgendwie helfen? Tut mir leid wegen heute Abend.
Sorry, that tonight turned out so... differently.
That's all right. I'm really quite glad that you're here.
Warum?
Thanks. But...
Why?
While Rachel's dealing with all of this, it's a relief to know she can talk to you. How are you doing, Chloe?
How am I doing?
Your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
Super seltsam, mir geht's besser als Rachel. Ja, lass mal Rachel mal ganz kurz raus. Macht auch nichts besser.
I guess I'm not great. Rachel and I were really happy a few hours ago, and now...
Maybe you can see why James wanted to keep this a secret. There are many painful things about Rachel's past, including my own role in hiding the truth.
James hat gelogen, da ist er mal im Bemaß. Sarah hat das Geld vorgezogen. Ich verstehe, warum er gelogen hat. Er wollte seine Tochter beschützen. Und erzähl mal einer kleinen Kind, ja, eigentlich hast du eine andere Mutter, aber die hat zu viel Drogen genommen, hat sich ja ins Koma wahrscheinlich auch gesoffen und wollte aber lieber das Geld. Also, du warst ja scheißegal. Aber du hast eine andere Mutter.
Sarah shouldn't have taken money over seeing her daughter.
You know, I am so thankful to her that she did. It gave me the opportunity to be Rachel's mother. I never knew how much I could love someone until I had Rachel.
But hearing the truth after all these years hurt Rachel more than anything.
I'm not happy with James for the whole way this came out.
You're not happy with James? What about what he did at the Overlook?
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
You're right. I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about me or James. Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sarah is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband. His entire life is about keeping people safe. Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chloe.
Klar, dass er ihr das irgendwann gesagt haben muss. Ein bisschen früher wäre wahrscheinlich auch nicht schlecht gewesen. Weil, ganz ehrlich, egal, was man verheimlicht oder was man lügt, irgendwie kommt doch die Wahrheit immer ans Licht. Und dann wird es nur noch schlimmer. Wie in dem Fall.
I wonder what James is thinking right now.
Also, das habe ich schon gemacht. Entschuldigung.
This must be hard for you too, Mr. Amber.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sarah. I've dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused. Her addiction has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
Ja, sollte Rachel das nicht selbst nicht scheinen, was fürchten sie, was Sarah tun wird? Ich verstehe halt echt beide Seiten. Wenn er so von ihr verletzt wurde und mit ansehen musste, wie sie alle anderen verletzt hat, auch seine eigene Tochter, dass er nicht will, dass Rachel dann die Sarah trifft, ist klar. Aber ich verstehe es halt auch von Rachel, die nur die eine Seite hört. So blöd das jetzt klingt, aber sie kennt Sarah nicht und will sich wahrscheinlich selbst überzeugen. Oh, das ist alles so kompliziert.
I don't understand. Are you afraid that Sarah would do something to Rachel?
I don't think she would deliberately harm anyone. But addicts can cause tremendous harm without meaning to.
Yeah. But Rachel's not a baby anymore.
Listen to me. Sarah brought criminals and drug dealers into our home. She put Rachel in serious danger just to chase her habit.
Do you think Sarah is involved with any of the drug dealers around here?
It wouldn't surprise me if she were. That's who she is. Chloe, I believe Rachel trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
This is where I ask you to do as your conscience dictates. But please, put my daughter's safety first.
That is something I will always do.
She's so young. You are too. But I know you've experienced loss. Protect her from that. Please.
I'll do what I can. I care about her too, you know?
I know. Thank you.
So, ich muss mich später entscheiden, ob ich Rachel sage, ja, triff sie oder triff sie nicht, das will ich nicht selber entscheiden, das muss sie selber machen, wenn dann, oder Spiel.
Rachel took that pretty hard. I should see if she's okay.
Ich auch.